So today we are going to start with the NoSQL databases. NoSQL stands for not only SQL. See, first of all we need to understand what exactly the NoSQL databases is, why it's required. Like we are having some great and good options are already there, like we are having Oracle is the big databases, like we are having SQL Server is, it's again a product by the Microsoft, and it's more or less like Oracle. It's really good, and it's a lot of companies are using already the MySQL SQL Server. IBM DB2 is also there. We are having the Postgres databases is also there. So we are having the different category of the databases is already there. Then the question is, why now the concept of NoSQL is there? So first of all, we need to understand what exactly the NoSQL databases is and what is the use of these NoSQL databases. Before I'm going to start in the detail of the NoSQL, it's my simple question. And with this question, you will find it out why the NoSQL databases is required and what is the purpose of this. Suppose everyone right now, everyone just using the Facebook and all. Suppose I'm just going to use the Facebook, and on the Facebook, I'm just going to put a post over there. And suppose this post is related with the coronavirus. Yeah, like it's a kind of dangerous and all. Suppose this is my post, and naturally for this particular post, what you need to do, the people can put the multiple comments over there. Suppose someone will get agree with me, someone will get disagree with me. So might be someone will make the comment. Someone will make the comment like good, someone will make the comment like not agreed, someone will make the comment with the multiple lines, someone will make the comment with the multiple line of comments and all, someone will put the comment with single image, some images will be there, might be someone is going to put the comment with some video. And might be someone going to put the comment with some audio. Now my question is, what you need to do, you need to store all these comments in the database. This is my simple question. My question is, what you need to do, this was my post, and you just need to store all these data with the databases. Now it's a big question for me, like what database I have to use. Suppose I'm just going to consider the Oracle. If I'm going to use the Oracle, then now the thing is that in the table, how I will accommodate all these data? The problem is, here we are having 4 characters only, here we are having 3 characters, here we are having the group of words over there, multiple lines is there, and again we are having the images is there, again we are having the video is there, again we are having the audio is there, and again the problem is like multiple user is going to make the comment. So the thing is that, number one, the problem is how to store this different category of the data. And first of all, this data is not structured. These are unstructured data. Unstructured data means it can be anything. And again, the problem is the volume of the data. Multiple comments can be there. So that's the challenge. The real challenge was how to accommodate the structured data. How to accommodate the unstructured data. Number one. Again, the challenge was, what about the volumes? Use volumes of data is there. That's again a challenge. And these two questions, how to accommodate the unstructured data? What about the volumes? If the volume is too high, how to store this category of the data? That was the question. And for these questions, if I'm going to consider the Oracle, then it's again the problem. How you can accommodate the data in the Oracle? Because Oracle is what? Suppose I'm just going to give the example of Oracle. Oracle is basically, it's a kind of relational kind of databases is there. It's talking about the relational. It's talking about the data should be there in the row and column format. Row and column format. But the problem is, in NoSQL databases, as such, we don't have the fixed number of row. I don't have the fixed number of columns. So that was the real challenge, how to accommodate the unstructured data. And what about the volumes of data, if the volumes of data is too big? And these two questions was there. And due to these two questions, the answer is, for all these kind of queries, we are having the NoSQL, not only SQL. This was the first challenge.
Now, I'm going to give you the brief description about the NoSQL. Remember, before this NoSQL, we need to understand, like in 70s, at that particular time, there was no any concept of databases. Storage was there, just to store the data, the file system was there. The people were just using the file system, like file handling kind of thing, and every data gets stored with the files and all. But from late 70s or from early 80s and all, the concept of relational databases comes in the picture, RDBMS comes in the picture. And from that particular days to till date, and even in the future, this concept is there, like relational databases system we are talking about. And the basic property of the relational databases system is, already you are familiar with, number one, data must be in tabular format. Data must be in tabular format. And again, the second thing is, there must be some relation. So, this was the basic fundamental behind the relational databases. Like, the data must be in the tabular format and there must be some relation. See, now the problems comes in the picture, because this time we are talking about, this is the time for the big data. Big data means what? The data that's bigger in the size is known as the big data. It's a simple definition. The data bigger in the size is known as the big data. And the entire big data is based on the three V's. The three V's it's based on. And the three V's is, number one, its volume, its velocity, and its variety. The entire big data is based on the three things, three concepts. Its volumes of data, velocity we are talking about. Can you think about, like, suppose right now we are talking about the social media, suppose Facebook, suppose WhatsApp, Instagram. Right now we are talking about the search engines. Suppose we are talking about the stock market data. Suppose we are talking about the weather forecasting data. Suppose we are talking about the satellite data. Can you think about what is the volumes of data? Per second I am talking about. It's not 1 or 2 days. How many data get generated by the Facebook? How many data get generated by the YouTube? How many data get generated by the search engine? How many data get generated by the satellite and all? Again, the velocity. Can you think about what is the speed of the data? And again, the variety. What are the different category of the data? In some places you need to store the video, in some places you need to store the audio, in some places you need to put the multiple images over there.
In some places you need to store the single character. In some places you need to store the multiple lines over there. So this is the time for the big data, because it's the internet revolution. It's the era of internet. At present we are talking about the internet. Internet means what? We are talking about the big data. The question was how to accommodate all these data in the database. That was the big question. The question was how to accommodate the big data into the database. Big data means what? Where the sizes use different varieties, different category of the data is there, which are different volumes and different velocity. The challenge was how to accommodate these data with the database. All the existing databases, means I am talking about the relational databases, was not capable enough to handle these kind of data. All the relational databases was capable enough to handle the relational databases, means tabular databases, but the challenge was how to accommodate the big data, and this particular challenge was the reason behind the development of NoSQL databases. Got the question? Got the answer? Why the NoSQL databases is there? NoSQL stands for not only SQL. Now there is some meaning of this. Listen, all the databases, like the old databases, were based on the SQL languages. All the databases were based on the SQL languages. But in the NoSQL databases, what the NoSQL is saying, no, we don't have any standard language. We don't have any standard language. It's not necessary to use the SQL. We are not bound to use the SQL. Why we will go for the SQL? So all the internet companies like Facebook, like Google, like Twitter, all the internet based companies build a different concepts of the databases, and that concept of the databases is known as NoSQL. So the purpose of NoSQL databases was how to accommodate the volumes of data, how to accommodate different varieties of data with the great speed. That was the reason behind the development of the concept of the NoSQL databases. See, if I am going to talk about the earlier databases like SQL databases, SQL based databases, and if I am going to talk about the NoSQL based databases, NoSQL means what? See, there is a difference between the SQL based databases and NoSQL databases. SQL based databases, like what? It was the relational. All the databases was relational over there. Relational was the use concept for that. Remember, NoSQL is what? It's a non-relational databases. They are not talking about the relation, number one. They are not talking about the relation. Now, the concept of database is totally different in the sense of NoSQL databases. They are not talking about the relation. So, it's a non-relational kind of databases there. Number one, they are talking about the tables. But the NoSQL databases, it's not only the table they are talking about. They are also talking about the documents. Different categories of the databases are there. It's a document-based database. It's graph-based database. It's graph-based database. Graph-based databases. It's not only the table. They are also talking about the document. They are talking about the graph-based databases. So there is the different categories of the databases and all. Remember, in the SQL databases, what you need to do, remember, every time you need to purchase the license and all. License and all. Suppose I am going to use the Oracle. For that, I need to purchase the license. If I am going to use the SQL Server, for that, I need to purchase the license. But for this, these all are the NoSQL databases are open source. You don't need to purchase the license and all. And again, the SQL databases, like every time you need to purchase the good hardware, like you need to purchase the server, you need to purchase the client, then you need to make the connectivity and all. So good hardware need to purchase and all. It's a normal system. It's a normal PC. You don't need to put some extra efforts for the hardware and all. It's a normal PC we are talking about. In the relational databases, like every time. Now, one important thing. Earlier, I was just talking about what is the use of this NoSQL databases. And my answer was, if I want to store the unstructured data, if I want to store the volumes of data, if I want to store the big data, the answer is NoSQL. Now, other than this, one important thing. Like in the SQL, tell me one thing, you people are comfortable with the Oracle. In the SQL, what you need to do? Always you need to apply the joins. Always you need to apply the subqueries. Can you tell me, like, join in subquery, it's good for performance or what? Naturally, if I am talking about the joins, if I am talking about the subqueries, these are not good for the performance point of view. Suppose we are having the 10 tables, and if I am going to apply the join and then I am going to fetch the data, it's again a difficult task for the performance and all. If you are going to put the subqueries, select within a select, within a select, within a select, it's a really difficult task, because now we are dealing with the volumes of data. It's not the simple data we are talking about. Now we are dealing with the volumes of data. So because the volume is already too high, so it's not possible to apply the joins to subqueries and all. It's again degrade the performance. So in the NoSQL, the good thing is you don't need to put the joins, you don't need to put the subqueries. So this is the really the good thing about the NoSQL databases that we are talking about. In the layman term, I am just giving you the definition, like the differences between the regular SQL databases and the NoSQL databases. And these are few differences that you can analyze. Like in the NoSQL databases, it's basically for the, it's a kind of non-relational and open source databases. And again, one important thing that I need to mention over there, it's always talking about the structured data. And it's talking about the non-relational, it's talking about the structured as well as unstructured. It's always talking about the structured as well as unstructured databases. Now, so if I'm just going to conclude this, why the NoSQL is, NoSQL stands for not only SQL. Number one, why the NoSQL databases is there? Because this is the time, this is the era of the internet. In this particular era of the internet, what we are talking about, we are talking about the big data. The challenge was how to accommodate this big data into the table, in the database. So if I am talking about the traditional databases was not capable enough to handle these kind of data. Because these databases was developed in early 80s. Now we are in the 21st century. And now we are talking about the internet. We are talking about the big data. So the purpose was how to accommodate the big data and all. That's why all the internet vendor means I am talking about Google, I am talking about the Facebook, I am talking about the Twitters and other companies that makes a forum, and that particular forum was involved with the development of the NoSQL category of the database. And this is what exactly the purpose of this NoSQL databases is. Earlier the concept was SQL was there. SQL was based on the relational data model. NoSQL is basically, it's a non-relational. SQL was based on the table. NoSQL is based, it's not only the table, they are based on the table, document, graph based database, different category of the databases there. In the SQL, all you need to purchase a license and all, that's again the costly thing. But in NoSQL, you don't need to purchase the license, it's open source, free of cost available. And again, for the SQL, always you need to be put the good hardware equipments over there, like server will be there, client will be there, server will be the high configuration, machine will be there. But for the NoSQL, you just need to use the normal PCs and all. In the SQL, again you need to put the joins, you need to put the subqueries, and join and subquery is not good for the performance. In the NoSQL, we don't have the joins, we don't have the subqueries. The reason behind that, we are dealing with the volumes of data. So, in short, if I am going to summarize the NoSQL, number one, NoSQL is going to support the unstructured data. Unstructured data means what? The data can be in any form. Data can be in any form. Like it's a single line data, it's a multi-line data, it's multiple data, it's a single data, it's an image, it's a video, it's an audio, anything. Number two, it's an open source. Cost wise again, we don't need to purchase, it's a regular hardware we required. See, when we are talking about the NoSQL, now the purpose is, earlier the concept was different. Earlier the concept was, if we are having the data, data must be in a structured format, data must be in the proper format, data must be in the tabular format. If table is there, there must be some relation. This was the concept earlier. Now, in the NoSQL, only the concept is how to store the data. In NoSQL, only the concept is how to store the data. Whatever the data is there, whether it's a duplicate data, or it's a garbage data, or it's a duplicate data, or it's a unstructured data, the purpose is how to store the data. Number one, the purpose is 24 multiply 7 availability. That's the purpose. The purpose is fast access. So, the purpose of the NoSQL database is totally different in compared to SQL databases. The NoSQL databases is talking about how to accommodate the data, whatever the category of the data, whether it's a duplicate data, whether it's a unique data, whether it's an audio category of the data, it's a structured data, the purpose is how to store the data. The purpose is how we can achieve the 24/7 availability. How we can access the data rapidly, fast access. So, this is the primary purpose of NoSQL databases. Now, you people tell me, like when we start the database, always the people are talking about the normalization. Normalization means we need to avoid the repetitive data, we need to avoid that. Always for that we need to maintain the relationship and all. Now, the NoSQL data is not going to talk about the normalization. They are just talking about how to store the data. It's only the fundamental is how to store the data, that's it. And believe me, what the NoSQL is saying, if we are having the duplicate set of data, that's really good. Because the NoSQL databases works in the cluster. Like we are having the chain of computers will be there. Like they are talking about the cluster. And in normally in the NoSQL databases, what happens? Like we are having the set of data A is there. It will copy the same data over there also. And it will copy the same data over there. In case of some problem is there with this particular server or system, in that case you can get the data from this location only. If some problem is there with this system, you will get the data from this location only. So for the safety purpose, it stores the data on the multiple clusters, on the multiple machines right now.
Like cluster is totally a different kind of thing, but right now, just for your information, we can consider it as a different system. So what I'm saying, like NoSQL is only talking about how to store the data, how to accommodate the data. If the data is duplication is there, that's the good thing. It's not the bad thing in the NoSQL. We don't need to apply the join. We don't need to apply the subqueries. What exactly we are looking for? We are looking for like how to store the data. That's it. So this is what exactly the NoSQL databases is. One important aspect is also there that I need to talk. Suppose we are talking about the relational databases. In the relational databases, suppose this is the table we are having. Employee table is there. In the employee table, we are having the employee number. We are having the employee name. We are having the basic pay of the employee. We are having the dearness allowance. We are having the traveling allowance. We are having the house rent allowance. We are having the deduction. Okay. Employee number is this. Employee name is this. And the basic pay of the employee is suppose $5,000. And DA. DA I am not going to calculate over here. We will calculate through the programs and all. And we have now, suppose what I need to do, I need to display the salary slip. I need to display the salary slip of the employee. My question is, we are having a table. As a programmer, we are having the table, and this is the table we are having. It's employee number, employee name, and basic pay. So this is the table we are having. Now what I need to do, using this table, and again we are having the number of days presence of that particular user, NOD, number of days. So in this particular month, suppose this employee was present for 30 days. Suppose the another record is there. Another record is here. And his presence was like 20 days. On 10 days, he was on leave and all. Now, what I need to do, we just need to create the salary slip for this. So, I will fetch the record and all. I will got the basic pay. Suppose basic pay is 5,000. Now I need to calculate the DA. I will calculate like 50% of the basic pay, so it is 2500. Again, I need to calculate the HRA. HRA is suppose 10% of the basic pay, so I am just going to give like 500. And deduction I am going to give like deduction is of 10% of the basic pay, so I am just going to give like 500. So now I need to calculate the total salary. I am going to calculate the total salary. The total salary will be like 5,000, like 5,000 plus 2500 plus 500, so like it's 8,000. In 8,000, now we need to minus the deduction and all. It's 500 I need to deduct, so the total salary is going to be 7,500. Now this is the result I need to display for this record. Again, for this particular record, again you need to calculate all these things on the basis of percentile and all. So what I'm trying to say, like what the data we are having in the table and what we need to display, that's a totally a different issues. Like it's totally a different kind of thing. Like we are having this category of the data, and what I need to display, I need to display the data like this. This is called impedance mismatch. What exactly the impedance mismatch is, what exactly we need to display and what the data we are getting is totally different. Lot of manipulation I need to put over here, and after putting all these manipulation, I am going to display the total salary. This is called impedance mismatch. As a programmer,
always you need to write lot of things, you need to manipulate lot of things over there, then you will be able to display the result. This was the problem with the relational databases. Now, what the non-relational databases is saying in place of this? Non-relational databases is saying that, okay, you don't need to do like this. What you can do, you can put all the data into the table itself. Everything will be there in the table. The NoSQL databases is saying like employee number, employee name, basic pay, and again, we are going to give the DA, we are going to give the HRA, we are going to give the deduction, we are going to give the number of days, we are going to give the salary, everything will be there. Everything will be there. So DA will be 2500, like HRA will be 500, like deduction will be 500, like number of days will be 30, total salary I am just going to give like 7500. So what I am trying to say, the NoSQL databases is saying, what is the use of, like, why you are writing all these kind of stuff over there? Just do one thing, put all these data into the table and display the data, that's it. So NoSQL databases is saying that, okay, don't you need to write the code and all. The NoSQL databases is saying like, okay, put all the data all together in the tables and all and display the data, that's it. You don't need to put the multiple manipulations and all, because it's a time consuming task, will take time. The NoSQL database is saying, okay, do one thing, put all the data into the table and display that. Now, you can ask me the question, suppose this particular employee don't have the basic pay, or this particular employee, he is working in a different company, he don't have the DA, then what I will do? The NoSQL has the answer for this. Okay, we are having the employee, name is there, basic pay is there, and we don't have the DA and HRA for this employee. We don't have that. He is working in some different companies. So how we can do that? No problem. In the in NoSQL, we don't need to worry about all these things. In the NoSQL, we don't need to worry about all these things. Like we are having the different fields. See, here we are having these kind of fields. And here we are having these kind of fields. And what you can do, you can put all together in a single table. And suppose the table is employee. This is the beauty of the NoSQL databases. You don't need to worry about the fields and all. You can put any category of the data. Suppose I am just going to put the employee data, and suppose in the place of employee data, someone is going to put like it's a worker information. So I am just going to put the worker name and worker salary. See, the name is this. We don't have the employee number for this, and this is his salary. Remember, these are having the different set of records is there. But the thing is that in all set of the record, we are having the different fields is there. Like here we are having worker's name, here we are having worker's salary. And all together, they are in the single table. That's the beauty of this NoSQL databases. It's unstructured. We don't have any predefined schema. We don't have any predefined schema. Like in Oracle, all the predefined schema was there. If you are going to define the table, it will be the table, employee number, employee name, salary, department number, department name, location. It will be there. Like, but if the same data I am going to put the in the NoSQL, in the first record I am going to put the employee number and employee name. That's it. And in the second record, I am going to put the employee number, employee name, and salary. In the third record, I am going to put the employee number, employee name, salary, the DA, the HRA. In the fourth record, I am just going to put the, we don't have the employee number, employee name, and salary, and all. So this is the beauty of this NoSQL databases. In the NoSQL database, it's like we don't have any predefined schema. No predefined schema, no predefined structure. So this is what exactly the NoSQL databases is, and this is how we can work with the NoSQL databases. So this was my answer regarding the NoSQL databases, like what exactly the NoSQL databases is, what was the reason behind the development of the NoSQL databases, and what is the advantages of the NoSQL databases. Now, we are having the different category of the NoSQL databases are there. We are having the different category of the NoSQL databases are there. Like we are having the key value pair database. We are having document based database. We are having the document based database. We are having like graph based database. So we are having the different category of the NoSQL databases are there. It's a document based database. We are having the graph based database. We are having the tabular databases. So we are having the different category of the NoSQL databases. And first of all, under the NoSQL databases, what we are going to start with, we are going to start with the MongoDB. And this MongoDB is basically what? This MongoDB is, again, it's a kind of NoSQL database. What types of NoSQL database? It's a kind of document oriented NoSQL database. It's a kind of document based NoSQL databases. Or we can say it's a kind of document oriented databases. So I'm just going to show you the example of MongoDB databases. Like if I'm talking about the Oracle, like we are having this will be the category of the database, like employee number, employee name and salary. Like in the employee number you will put the values, employee name you will put the values, and salary you will put the values. But this was the example I'm just talking about the SQL based databases. Now if the same thing, if I need to put in the MongoDB, how we can do that? It's a document oriented database. Everything is document over here. So this is how I will put the data, like EMP. Under the EMP I will put employee number. Employee number is of type 11, comma. Again I will put like employee name. Employee name will be SS. And again I will put the salary. Like the salary will be 3030. Yeah, this is my first record. In this next record I am just going to put, like, it's not necessary that I am going to use the employee number. I will use ENO, employee number. I will just use the name in the place of ename. I don't have the salary, I am not going to give that. Suppose we are having the mobile number for the employee, I will put the mobile number over there. So this is what, this is the key, and this is what, this is the value. Remember, in the MongoDB, this is the structure. This is how you can put the value. Remember, when we are talking about the MongoDB, in MongoDB, what we can do, like, table is known as collection over there. Like in SQL, normally we use table, the term table. But in MongoDB, for the table, we use the term collection over there. In SQL, normally we use the term record. In MongoDB, it's not a record, it's a document. So the table of normal SQL databases is known as collection over there. And the record of the normal databases is known as documents over there. Okay, I will discuss all these things in the detail, but for the time being, what we have to start with? We have to start with the MongoDB. MongoDB is what? It's a kind of NoSQL databases. And what category of the NoSQL databases? It's a document oriented databases. Right now, like Facebook, Twitter, they all are using this MongoDB databases. In the NoSQL databases, MongoDB is the most popular one that people are using right now. So the first thing that we need to understand, how to install the MongoDB. To install the MongoDB, what I need to do? The simple process that I need to perform. I'm just going over there. I am just going to write MongoDB download. www.mongodb.com. We are having MongoDB download center. Better option is just click on this MongoDB download center. Now, what we need to do? We need to install the MongoDB. I need to click on this server. And we are having the MongoDB community server. Free of cost, it's available. We don't need to do anything. And remember, the good thing about this MongoDB is these are the open source and platform independent. These are the open source and platform independent. So what we need to do, we can download the MongoDB. The current version of the MongoDB is 4.2.5. The other versions is also there. Now, the second thing, we are having the different types of operating system support is there. We can install the MongoDB with Windows or the Linux or the Unix or Ubuntu, or you can install the MongoDB with any operating system. I need to install with the Windows, so I'm just going to get the Windows. And this is the different package. It's talking about the zip file or MSI. I'm just going to take the MSI. It's installer by default. Going to click download. So we have to start with the MongoDB community server. Now, thank you for downloading this. The downloading will get start. So what we need to do, we need to start with MongoDB community server. MongoDB community server. It's a free of cost, so we don't need to worry about that. So MongoDB community server that we are going to start with, and it's installing. The size of this file is 263 MB. So it's installing right now. From the database prospect, from the Oracle prospect, if I am going to analyze the MongoDB, this will be really easier for us as a student, because we don't need to write the constraint. We don't have the unique and foreign key. We don't have the relationship, number one. We don't have the joins, we don't have the subqueries, we don't have the triggers, even we don't have the procedure, we don't have the cursor in that particular way. So what exactly we need to do if I am talking from the prospect of Oracle, MySQL or SQL Server? So what we need to do, we just need to create the table. It's not a table, it's a collection. Under the collection, we need to put some values. It's a document. So the thing that we need to understand, how to create the collection, how to put the values, how to apply the insert, update, delete operations, how we can filter the record. These are the basic things that we need to remember. Listen, these NoSQL are basically, these are the new things in the industry. New in the sense of, I am talking about from the prospect of Oracle. Oracle Corporation was established in 1976 and the first product get released in late 70s. It's around 78-79. The first product get released. It's 2020 we are talking about. So it's around 50 years. It's 40-50 years we are talking about. And these MongoDB, these NoSQL, these are the new concepts. So right now a lot of things is going on. That's why it's in developing phase. And these all the databases like Oracle, SQL Server, they are the mature one. Okay, so we are having the MongoDB get installed over there and downloaded over there. And I'm just going to click on this. And it will get installed. Yeah. Welcome to the MongoDB 4.2.5. Click on this. Accept the license term. What you need to do, I'm just going for the complete installation. Complete. Install MongoDB as a service. Yes, it's fine. Service name. This is the data directory and this is the log directory. By default, it will get installed with the program file. Under the program file, the MongoDB will be there. Next. And one important thing that you need to remember is talking about the install MongoDB Compass. Don't click on this, uncheck it, otherwise it will take time, it's a time consuming one. It's a kind of IDE that we can work for. So right now I'm just going to remove this, next, and click on this install. It will install this MongoDB. MongoDB Inc. This is the name of the company this product belongs to. So this is the first thing that we need to do. Yeah, it gets installed. Finish. If I'm going to start with program C colon, under the C we are having the program file, under the program file we are having MongoDB. Yeah, MongoDB is there. Under the MongoDB we are having the server over there. Under the server we are having 4.2 is there, and then again we are having the bin folder over there. Under the bin we are having the two file, one is MongoD and one is Mongo. So under this bin folder we are having the two files over there. What we need to do, how to start under this bin folder we are having the two file. Number one, we are having the MongoD and we are having MongoD and we are having Mongo. This MongoD is basically it's a server. So we need to start the server first, then we start with Mongo. So I'm just going to click on this MongoD. But it gets stopped. One important thing that we need to do within the C drive, what we need to do, we need to create a folder by the name of data. Under the data folder we need to create a folder by the name of DB. So I'm just going to create a folder by the name of DB. Now we are having the program file, MongoD, MongoDB, server 4.3, bin, we are having MongoD. I'm just going to click on this and it's going to install the it's going to start the MongoDB server. So MongoDB server is going to start first. Now after clicking on this, it's working. We don't need to do anything over here. I'm just going to click on this Mongo. Yeah, now this greater than is there, that means everything is perfectly fine and now you can start your work. So what we need to do, at first we need to click on this MongoD and Mongo, but before this we need to remember one important thing. In C drive you need to create a folder by the name of data, and within the data create a folder by the name of DB. After that, under the program file in MongoDB you need to click on this MongoD, and then you need to click on Mongo. It will start and you will get the prompt like this. This is the MongoDB prompt. Now you are at this particular prompt. What I need to do, I'm just going to change the color and all, because it's black window, it's not visible properly. Properties, color, screen text, screen background, font, I'm just going to give like bold. Yeah, okay. Now what I need to do, remember in MongoDB always we need to write everything in a small, so I'm just going to use clear.
clear is the command to clear the screen. CLS. CLS is the command to clear the screen. CLS. CLS is the command to clear the screen. Now, first of all, remember in MongoDB what I need to do. I want to see, I am just writing DBS, DB, and we are getting the test. Test is the default database in MongoDB. Test is the default database in the MongoDB. If I want to see the list of the database, we can use so DBS. These are the default databases, like admin is there, config is there, local is there. Test is the default databases. So the command is there like db to get the name of current database. Current database. Next, what we are having, so dbs to see the list of the databases. List of databases. If I want to see the list of the databases, we can use sodbs. Now, what I need to do, first of all, I want to create the database. So, how we can do that? I am just writing use, and suppose I want to create a database by the name of test. Use test. Now, switch to db test. Remember, use test. Use test means what? You are creating a database. If you are creating a database by name of test, and remember, if database is not there, then it will create a database by the name of test, and then open that. But if the database is there, then it will not create the database, it will just open the database. Now, if I am going to write the command like db, my database is test now. Now, what I need to do, so our database is ready. Now, what I need to do? I need to create some table over there. So, how we can create the table? Remember, it's not a table, it's a collection that I want to do. So, if I want to create a collection, how we can do that? I am just writing db dot create collection. And what collection we are talking about? Remember, it's going to follow the naming convention just like Java. It's going to follow the naming convention just like Java. This naming convention is known as Pascal convention. Remember the naming convention in any programming language, we are having the naming convention, like one is called Camel convention, and one is called Pascal convention. Camel convention, like suppose in Java, if I am going to write draw a string, how we write? Like draw a string, like draw. It's in a small case, but the second next letter is in upper case. Suppose I am just going to write stream writer. Writer. So, S is a small case and W is in uppercase. This is Camel convention. Pascal convention, like console. I am just going to use write line. See, the first letter is in uppercase. So, this is Pascal convention and this is Camel convention. Remember, the Java is going to follow the Pascal Camel convention. Like .NET, C sharp and all, it's going to follow the Pascal convention. So in MongoDB,
it's just going to follow the same convention over there. It's a Pascal convention. Sorry, it's a Camel convention going to follow the MongoDB. So I'm just going to write db.create collection. And what collection I need to start with? EMP. So it's going to create a collection called EMP. But right now, because this MongoDB is schemaless. Schemaless means what? We don't have the structure. So we don't need to define any structure over there. So now we are having the collection. So what we can do? We can insert the value over there. So how we can do that? So I'm just going to insert some values. So how we can do that? I'm just going to write db.emp. Remember, it's highly case sensitive. If I'm going to put emp in the uppercase, like e is in the uppercase, always I need to follow the same. If I'm going to give the e in a small case, it will create a different collection. So I'm writing db.emp.insert. db means database. db.emp.insert. And what I need to put? Remember, this MongoDB is just going to follow the JSON format, JavaScript object notation, and basically its key and value pair is there, always the key and value. This is the pair that we need to follow. So I'm just going to follow the key and value. And remember, if I'm talking about the JSON, then the key and value will be there in this braces, will be in this braces. So I need to maintain this braces over there. So I'm just going to write db.emp.insert braces. I'm just going to put the imply number 101, comma. I'm going to give the imply name, and suppose the imply name is Santos. I'm going to put the salary, and suppose salary for the Santos is 10,000. So this is how you can put the values. This is how you can put the values, and we are getting the message right result and inserted number of record inserted 1. Again, I need to put some values. I'm going to put that db.emp.insert, and again multiple values will be there. So I'm just going to use the braces in the braces, and it's not necessary that you are going to use. We can also put everything in the double quotation. That's not a problem, but ideally it's a number, so we can avoid this. Again, suppose for this field I am not going to give the double quotation, it's perfectly fine, as such there is no any problem, because it's a field name, so it's not necessary to give this. But if I am going to give this, there is no any problem. It's the same thing. Suppose I am going to put the values like this, I am going to put the single quotation, again that's not a problem. Again, that's not a problem. I'm going to use the single quotation. And here I'm not going to give anything, or here I'm going to give this double quotation. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. If I'm going to put the imply number, in the place of imply number, I'm going to give ENO. In the place of ENO, suppose I'm going to give the, in the place of name, I'm just going to give name, ename. In the place of salary, I'm just going to give the sal. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. You don't need to use any semicolon at all. The important thing is, see, db.emp.insert. Insert is a function. That's why we are using this parenthesis over there. Because it's going to follow the JSON format. Its key and value will be there. So this is the key and this is the value. And always we need to use the colon over there, key and value, that we are going to put. Suppose I need to put the multiple values. If I need to put the multiple values, so how we can do that? For the multiple values, what we can do, we can use the array. We can use the array. This is the array. So this is the first value I'm going to give. This is the first value I'm going to give. And again, comma. Again, I'm going to give the another values. Like name, colon. I'm just going to give like Alan Smith. And again, I'm going to give his salary over there. Like salary, I'm going to give like this. And see, as such, there is no any limitation. You can put n number of values and all. So I'm just going to close this braces. So we are going to insert the two record parallelly. The first record I'm going to put, and this is the second record I'm going to put. And because multiple record is there, so it will work like an array. And for the array, we are using this bracket. I'm just going to put this. Yeah, yeah. We are getting n inserted, number of record inserted is 2. So now in the EMP collection, we are having the different types of values. What I want to do, I want to see these values over there. So how we can do that? To display the data, we can use db.emp.find. Yeah, we are getting all these data like employee number, employee name, employee NO, name, ename is there, cell is there. So all we are getting like this. Remember, in MongoDB, you don't need to maintain the primary key and all. MongoDB by default maintain the object ID. This object ID is just a primary key. See, every object ID is different. Even though you can also put the object ID value, it's not like if I'm going to put the values over there. Here we can also put the object ID, that's not a problem. I'm just going to put underscore ID. Underscore ID is just the primary key by default. So I'm just going to put underscore ID, but it must be unique. It must be unique. Yeah. Again, I'm going to put the ID like 102. It must be unique. If I'm going to put the same ID, it will give the error. Duplicate key error. So by default, MongoDB is always going to follow the ID and all. It's just like the primary key kind of thing. Suppose I'm going to use db.emp.find and we are getting all these data. We are getting all these data. So this is the basic thing that how we can start the work and all. I'm just going to make edit, select all, enter. I'm just going to put all these things over there for your reference. How to put the values and all, how to create the databases, how to create the collection. So these are the basic things that you need to remember. It's fine.